This video covers exception handling as implemented by Visual Basic. Exception handling in Visual Basic is implemented using a try-catch block. Exception handling is used to detect and report error conditions and perform any type of recovery or program exit as required. There are a couple common errors that occur when trying to run a Visual Basic program. A data type mismatch is common, also an attempted divide by zero. This program reads the number of hours from a text box, which is text data, it's a string, and then attempts to convert that into a decimal value. An unhandled exception error is reported if one of the text boxes is left empty or has non-numeric error. This is because the convert to decimal CDEC function that is used to convert the text data from the text box is only able to process numeric data. The program fails with a runtime error and an unhandled exception error is reported. Here comes the try-catch block. Any code that can fail should be placed in a try-catch block so that the program can handle the error instead of the program failing with a runtime error. Besides data type conversions, another common exception that should be detected and processed is an attempted divide by zero. Here is an example for a different program. This program is going to read the total score for a class and then divide it by the number of participants. For example, if I read in the total score of 25 and the number of participants is 5, I'm going to divide the total score by the number of participants and compute the average score, which is going to be 5. The code for this example has no exception handling. Everything works fine as long as the data is good. But what happens if the user clicks the compute button when there is no data in those text boxes or if the data is non-numeric? The CDEC routines are unable to convert the non-numeric data into a number. The program exits with an invalid cast exception was unhandled error, and the program fails and it dies. Not very clean operation. Here is another problem that could happen. If the total score's input is 25 and the number of participants is entered as 0, there's going to be an attempt to divide by 0. The program will die again with the divide by 0 exception was unhandled. Our program, again, could have processed this internally instead of letting the program die and come up with some weird error message for the user. We can use the try-catch blocks to handle these exceptions inside the program so the user is not confronted with these weird error messages. I'll convert the data from the text boxes into decimal and do the division and put all of that inside the try block. I'll also put out the message to say average score. I'll put that in the result in the try block. If everything is fine, all of the code in the try block executes, and then we'll jump right around the catch and to the end try statement. If there is an error, what's going to happen is we'll end up catching the error. As soon as the error is detected, the code inside the try block is going to jump over to the section that says catch. We'll put out a message saying error. Input must be numeric. We can also have multiple catch blocks. That way, we can detect different errors and have different things happen with a different catch block. In this example, there's a catch exception as invalid cast exception. We'll put out a message saying error. In this example, it doesn't matter whether no data was entered or we're attempting to divide by zero. We'll still end up with the error. Input must be numeric. We can use multiple catch blocks to separate those two different type of errors. Right here is a catch as an invalid cast exception. Then we can put out the message error input must be numeric. We can also have a catch EX as divide by zero exception. This time we'll put out a message error. Enter non-zero value. Here's a little interesting thing, and dividing by zero for integers and decimal data types, dividing by zero causes an error that can be caught by the try-catch block. For using double data types, dividing by zero gives a result of infinity, which will not be an error and will not be caught by a try-catch block. Maybe you noticed the spot where it said catch ex as exception. An object's property contains information about an exception. You can write a catch that displays the default error message for that exception. You can change the catch blocks to say catch ex as exception. Inside the catch blocks, put in lblresult.txt equals ex.message. This is the end of the video for exception handling as implemented by Visual Basic. You will need this information to complete the labs and implement exception handling for your lab assignments. Have fun. This is really an important topic to know.